All right. Lesson number four. Let's talk about lesson number four. And we're doing good. It's 11:30, so we'll go through lesson number four. And I think we should be good for lunch. Actually, lesson four. Yeah, lesson four. All right. So lesson four, the result of our sins. Lesson number four, page number nine, the result of our sins. So up to this point, we've basically showed them that they're a sinner. We made that clear. There's none righteous, no, not one. You're not perfect. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We're all sinners, you know. Now, why am I showing you that? Here's why. Number one, what is the payment for our sin? Letter A, sin brings death. Sin brings death. That's your fill-in. For the wages of sin is death. Romans 5:12 says this, wherefore, as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, and so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned. Now, I put that verse in there. I don't normally use this verse in my presentation. I may use it as additional support if someone's kind of struggling with that idea, but I just want you to see that's a verse that kind of proves that point. So letter B, how this conversation may go. So I already showed them Romans 3:10. I already showed them Romans 3:23, and usually how I transition to Romans 6:23 is I'll say something along these lines. I'll say, you know, the Bible says there's none righteous, no, not one. Do you agree? You know, the word righteous means someone who's without wrong, someone who's perfect. You know, you didn't think you were perfect, did you? No, of course not. I'm not perfect. Well, look, in Romans 3:23, he takes it a step further, and he says, not only is there none righteous, but here it says, for all have sinned. The word all means that's everybody. I've sinned, you've sinned. Would you agree with that, that you're a sinner? Oh yeah, you know, I'm a sinner. And then I might say something like this. I say, well, the reason I showed you those verses is because of this. In Romans 6:23, the Bible says this. It says, for the wages of sin is death. Now, in Romans 6:23, we're going to come in our presentation to Romans 6:23 and only deal with that first part, for the wages of sin is death. We're going to come back later in the presentation, back to Romans 6:23, and deal with the second part of the verse, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. But right now we're talking about sin, so we're just focusing on that first part, for the wages of sin is death. So you read the verse, you reveal the truth. The Bible teaches that there are wages for our sin. You know, and sometimes I'll say something. I'm sure you're familiar with the word wages. You know, have you ever heard of this term before, minimum wage? A wage is something I earn. A wage is something I earn. You know, if I go to work, I earn wages. If I go work at McDonald's, they're going to pay me minimum wage. Now, here's the thing. When I work, what I earn is money. But when I sin, what I earn is death. Because the Bible says the wages of sin is death. You know, do you understand that? Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. We're gonna die because of our sin, right? And you know, and so you want to review that concept. You can say something like this: according to this verse, the wages or the payment of sin is what? What is it that we earn because of our sin? According to this verse. And sometimes I'll have the Bible in front of them, and I'll say, look, the Bible says for the wages of sin is what? What does that say? Oh, it says death. And you want to be careful with that. You know, obviously you're putting people on the spot too. But just make sure they understand that. All right. Number two, what is death? Letter A. There are two parts to death. Okay. And this is what you need to understand. There are two parts to death. There is in the Bible what's called the second death. Number one, the first death is a physical death. That's your fill-in. The first death is a physical death. Number two, the second death is the lake of fire. The second death is the lake of fire. If you turn your page there, you'll have letter B. So how this conversation may go, all right? The next verse I'll take them to is Revelation chapter 20, verse 14 and 15, and I'll read this. And I'll say, hey, look, the Bible says here, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And whosoever is not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. And sometimes what I'll do is I'll ask, when I read this verse, I'll say, look, here in Revelation 20, 14 and 15, it says, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And sometimes I'll just ask people, you ever heard of a second death before? And a lot of people are like, no, I've never heard of a second death, you know? And I'll say, well, look, in the Bible says that when we die physically, that's just the first death or the initial death. After that comes the second death, which is being cast into the lake of fire. Because notice what it says. It says, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. That's referring to hell. This is the second death. What is the second death? Being cast into the lake of fire is the second death. And I'll explain that to them, you know. And you can just, you just ask them, you know. So according to this verse, Is death just physical? No. It's also the lake of fire, right? That's the second death, all right? Number three in your notes there, page 10. Number three, understanding death and hell. Understanding death and hell. Letter A. Once we have showed them that they are sinners, all right? That's your fill-in. Once we have showed them that they are sinners, we need to show them the result of their sin. Letter B. Sin condemns us to hell because sin brings death, and death equals hell, all right? If you notice, what we're doing is we're bringing them through a process. We are bringing them to a place where they want to get saved. But in order to bring them there, they have to understand, you know? So we're starting with, hey, there's none righteous. You're not perfect. We're starting with all our sinners. Now we're showing them because of your sin, the result of your sin is death. The wages of sin is death. But it's not just a physical death. It's a second death, being cast into the lake of fire. We're explaining these things to them. So let me give you some things to write down. Go back to Romans 3:23 in your Bible, if you're marking up your Bible, Romans 3:23. And what I want you to do in front of Romans 3:23, I want you to write the number 2. So that's the second verse you're going to go to, right? And then next to, underneath, somewhere near Romans 3:23, write the reference Romans 6:23. And do me a favor, write Romans 6:23a. Romans 6:23a, all right? Because if you remember, we're going to focus on the first part of Romans 6:23. Later on, we're going to focus on the second part of Romans 6:23. So that'll be Romans 6:23b. But this time, we're just focusing on the first part. So you can write Romans 6:23a, and that kind of helps you understand what you're focusing on. So what we're doing is so you're going to have notes in your Bible that basically says, here's what you should have. Number one, Romans 3:10. I read it. I reveal the truth. I review the concept. I can't remember what the next verse is, but I have it written down, Romans 3:23. So I find Romans 3:23. It has a number 2 in front of it. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. I read the verse. I review it. I reveal the truth. I review it. I can't remember what the next verse I'm going to go to. It's Romans 6:23a. It's written right next to there. So then I go to Romans 6:23, and then we'll move on from there. So basically, we have came through lessons 1 through 4, and we have a little bit of time before lunch, so we're going to take time for some questions. But let me just review, because I know that this, for a lot of you, this is just new, especially if you haven't actually gone soul winning, your mind's going to not be able to kind of equate these things. So I just want you to understand, the goal is for you to have some structure to your presentation. And here's what we're trying to avoid. I've literally seen soul winners start with, like, let's start with Adam and Eve. Okay, you know, I mean, let's start right from the beginning, you know, because they don't know what to say, and they're just like talking about this and talking about that and talking about all these things. We're trying, look, you got 15, 20 minutes with this person, all right? TV has warped their mind to where they can basically pay attention for 15 minutes and then they need a commercial, all right? So we're trying to concise. We're trying to just get to the main things, the main points, and explain what the gospel is. So we start with, open the door. Hi, we're coming from Verity Baptist Church. Just wanted to give you and your family an invitation to church. Go to church anywhere? Oh yeah, I go to church down the street. Well, listen, more important than going to church, you know, if you were to die today, if you would go to heaven or hell, or maybe you're not sure and never thought about it, you know, I've never thought about it. Well, where would you like to go when you die? I mean, I think I'd like to go to heaven. Well, everybody would like to go to heaven, right? Did you know that the Bible actually says that you can be 100% sure you're on your way to heaven? I didn't know that. If I could show you from the Bible how you could know for sure that you're on your way to heaven, would you be interested in seeing it? Just take a few minutes. Well, sure, I've got some time, you know. Yeah, go ahead. Well, look, the Bible says here in Romans chapter number 3 and verse 10, it says, as it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. This word righteous, you know, the first part of the word, it says right. Someone who's righteous is someone who's always done right, never is without wrong. A word you and I would use would be perfect. You know, and what the Bible is saying here is that there's none righteous, there's none perfect, no one's perfect. Would you agree with that? You didn't think you were perfect, did you? No, of course not. I know I'm not perfect. Well, you know, yeah, we all get that, right? But notice, in verse 23, he takes it a step further. In verse 23, he says this, for all have sinned. That word sin, the Bible says that sin is a transgression of the law. When I break God's law, I sin. So for example, the Bible says, thou shalt not steal. If I steal something, I just sin. God says I shouldn't lie. If I tell a lie, that's a sin because I broke his law. And here's what this verse is saying. It's saying, for all have sinned. That word all, that means everybody. I've sinned, you've sinned. My partner here, man, he's a big sinner, okay? Would you agree with that, that we're all sinners? Oh, yeah, I agree with that. You know, we're all sinners. Well, here's the thing. The reason I showed you these verses, that there's none righteous and that we're all sinners, is because of this verse here. In Romans 6:23, the Bible says, for the wages of sin is death. You familiar with this word wages? You ever heard of this term before, minimum wage? Oh, yeah, it's what you get paid. Well, yeah, you know, if I go get a job at McDonald's, they're probably going to pay me minimum wage, right? A wage is something I earn. Now, when I work, what I earn is money. But according to this verse, when I sin, what I earn is death. Because notice what it says, for the wages of sin is death. Now, here's what you need to understand, though. When the Bible talks about death, it's not just talking about a physical death. Because in the Bible, there's more to death than just dying physically. Let me show you this verse in the book of Revelation. In Revelation 20:14-15, it says, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. Now, the lake of fire is referring to hell. Are you familiar with the concept of hell? Oh, yeah, I've heard of hell. Well, look, it says, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. You ever heard of the second death before? No, I've never heard of a second death. Well, you know, you may be asking yourself, well, what is a second death? But notice, it says they were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. What is the second death? The fact that they were cast into the lake of fire. See, the Bible says that death is not just a physical death. It's also the second death of going into the lake of fire. Verse 15 says, and whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Now, I'm going to stop there. That's how I give the gospel. You guys that have gone out soul winning with me, I mean, that's basically exactly how I go through it. And I say this, you know, up to this point, obviously we're not done. And here's what I want to encourage you. Say the same thing at every door. Use the same lame joke at every door. People think it's funny all the time. You know, just say the same thing. Get in a habit. Get in a way of doing it, a routine that's going to help you be consistent. You know, and of course, as their answers are different, you know, you're going to say different things. But get a plan. That's why we're teaching you this. We're trying to have you have a systematic plan. If you know what you're saying, you know where you're going, you don't have to sit there and spend 20 minutes, you know, shuffling through your Bible while they're kind of looking at you awkwardly because you don't know what the next verse. You already know I'm going to this next verse because I got it written down right here, all right? And here's the thing. Even if you say, well, I'm not very good at getting to the references, write the page number. You know what Revelation, you know, I can't get to Revelation that quickly, but you know what page number it is, write that page number. Help yourself to have